Hey guys, it's Ashley, and today, obviously, I'm bringing to you guys a Halloween-inspired makeup tutorial, and this was inspired by the comic book slash pop art makeup, and I absolutely love the way it came out. I went all out, even put on some contacts, and yeah, I really, really like it. I hope that you guys will too, and if you have any other requests whatsoever, feel free to leave them in the comments down below, and let's go ahead and jump into the tutorial. Okay guys, so the first thing I'm doing is I'm starting off with a clean and moisturized face, and then I'm going in with L'Oreal's True Match Foundation in the color W3, and I'm applying small dots all over my face, and then you can either blend this in with your fingers since it is a really blendable makeup, or you can just opt for a brush. Here I'm just using Sigma's Angled Kabuki Brush. Now, since we are going for flawless skin, I'm going in with L'Oreal's True Match Concealer right beneath my eyes. And this is in the color light, so that way it just really opens up the eyes a little bit. And I'm just going to blend it in with an angled kabuki brush. And I'm just going to repeat the same process to the other eye as well. Getting pumped up on the little bright things I bought. Now that we have perfect skin, I'm using Maybelline's Gel Eyeliner in Blackest Black with Sedona Lace's EB23 Angled Brush to fill in my eyebrows. And since we are going for a comic book slash pop art makeup look, we are going to use black. Obviously, we wouldn't use black on like a regular tutorial, but we are trying to get a specific look. So that is why we are using black. And I'm just kind of filling it in how I would fill in my normal brows. I'm just doing small strokes and blending the product up. Now, right here, I did decide that I wanted to do a little arch towards the front of my brow. You can kind of do whatever arch you feel that would suit your character the most. Fun again when I'm known. And my boys trip me up with their heads again, loving them. Everything's cool when we're all in line for the throne. Here, I'm just taking the same L'Oreal True Match Concealer in Light with the Sedona Lace EB23 brush to kind of clean up my eyebrows to get that quote, perfect eyebrow. And this can also help you thin out the brow a little bit to get your desired shape. After we've cleaned up the brows, we're just going to take a blending brush and clean up any concealer. We're going to blend out the edges and also blend out the front of our brow so that way it's like a little nice smooth grading effect. And then we are going to move right into the eyeshadow. I'm using Benefit's Creaseless Cream Shadow in Skinny Jeans. And I'm just using this as a base color, and I'm applying a thin layer onto my eyelids, and then I'm taking a Soho blending brush, and I'm blending out any harsh edges, so that way it's a smooth gradient effect from my lid to my brow bone. Now on to the fun part, the color. I'm using MAC's eyeshadow in the color Satellite Dreams, and I'm just simply applying this directly onto my lid, and I'm definitely not going above my crease, so just make sure you keep this color onto the lid, and you can make a distinct line. It doesn't matter because we're going to blend it out later. Making smart with the words again. Well, I'm bored. Because I'm doing this for the thrill of it, killing it, never not chasing a million things I want. Here, I'm just using Sedona Lace's EB09 brush, which is like a tapered blending brush, to blend out my crease because there is a pretty harsh edge. And all I'm really doing is just using small windshield wiper motions to blend out the color so that way there is a smooth grading effect from my crease to my brow bone. Going back into Maybelline's Gel Eyeliner in Blackest Black, I'm using this to define the crease of my eye,
Now you want to be sure not to apply this gel eyeliner directly into the crease. You want to apply it a little bit above so that way it doesn't smudge when you open your eyes, because we wouldn't want that to happen. And then I'm going back in with L'Oreal's Super Slim Liquid Liner in Carbon, and I'm using this to line the top of my eyes as usual, but there is a little bit of a catch. I did decide to do like a graphic liner to kind of change things up a bit from the usual like comic book pop art makeup tutorials. So it's really hard to explain, so I'm just going to let you guys watch and see what I did. Boys strip me up with their heads again, loving them. Everything's cool when we're all in line for the throne. But I know it's not forever. Baby, be the class clown. I'll be the beauty queen in tears. It's a new. Afterwards, I'm going in with some white cream makeup that I picked up from the Halloween store, and I'm applying it beneath my eyes to kind of give the illusion of like bigger comic book styled eyes. And then I'm just going to set that cream makeup with Benefit's eyeshadow and milk it, and I'm just simply applying this directly over top. And then I'm going back in with Maybelline's gel eyeliner in Blackest Black with my Sedona Lace EB23 brush, and I'm carving out like a new eye. So I want to make it seem like my eyes are really big and like comic book styled. So this is going to be the new like lash line that I'm creating right here. And then I'm just going to do the same exact thing to the other side. And then after that, I'm going to apply a pair of false eyelashes. And these are really, really like wispy towards the end, but you can apply any ones that you want. Then I'm going in with Pop Mascara in Black to blend my real lashes with my fake lashes. Let's go down to the tennis court and talk it up like yeah. And talk it up like yeah. And talk it up like yeah. And then of course we're going back into the Maybelline gel eyeliner in Blackest Black, and we are going to start really outlining our face. And this is specific to you. You don't necessarily have to like outline your face exactly how I'm doing it. I'm just kind of, you know, going with the flow here, doing my jawline, my nose, around my eyebrows. I'm also like tracing out my ear, and then I also decided that I wanted to like trace around where the wig ends so that way it looks like my hair, but it's really not. I am only as young as the minute is full of it. Getting pumped up on the little bright things I bought. But I know they'll never own me. Here I'm just using Maybelline's lipstick in Fuchsia Fever, and I'm applying this all over my lips because it's really bright and I wanted to bring more color into the face. And then obviously we are going back into the gel eyeliner, and I'm just using this to trace around my lips because this is a comic book look. And then I'm just adding like that fake shine to my lips with some white cream makeup. And then I decided that I also wanted to add some lower lashes. So I'm taking my Super Slim Liner by L'Oreal, and I'm just drawing a couple like, you know, fake lashes to kind of doll things up a little bit. And then this look doesn't really start to come together until we start to add the dots. So I'm using some acrylic paint in Brilliant Red, and I'm using the opposite end of one of like my makeup brushes, and I'm just applying small dots all over my face. And this does get a little bit time consuming, so you know, listen to some music, talk to a friend, text, go on Instagram, do something, because you will be here for a little bit. I'll be the
beauty queen. Okay guys, so this about does it for my comic book slash pop art makeup tutorial. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it, and if you do like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up so that way I know to keep doing Halloween tutorials. So yeah, I will see you guys next time. Bye guys. We're going at it tonight. Tonight there's a party.